Vanguardians, and welcome back to the channel for another episode of Destiny. Now, today we're going to be going over episode 11 of Xur's inventory and location review. So, the point of this series is to actually find Xur, tell you the location, and go over his inventory and tell you what you should and should not buy for that week of Xur. It's been 11 weeks since the Rise of Iron dropped, so this is episode 11, and I'm pretty excited about that because it's been a really good series on the channel and I kind of want to stick with it. So down over by the Crucible Quartermaster, Xur is located over here. If you click on the inventory of this tentacled faced bastard, you'll notice he's selling the Peregrine Greaves, Chest of Alpha Lupe, the Void Fang Vestments, and the Fourth Horseman. So he's basically selling Fourth Horseman, which is Granny's shotgun. He's selling the Void Fang Torments. He's selling the noob chest piece, and he's selling the scooter greaves. The scooter greaves, basically what I'm talking about is basically with shoulder charge, you just use shoulder charge an awful lot while you're wearing these, and you basically are scooting through the air. So we've also got Legacy Engram Helmet. This is only going to be purchased if you're going to be trying to get the year one helmet engrams, which aren't actually going to be good for your light. You actually shouldn't be using these, but if you want to complete your kiosk down by the Vanguard, purchase one of these at a time, decode them, and it's probably guaranteed 9 out of 10 times you'll get the one that you're missing. We've got Not a Toy for the Zealous Supercell. We've got Silver Bullet for the Nemesis Star. I actually have to purchase this because I don't have it yet, so thank God that the game finally gave it to Xur. We've also got Plasma Drive and Emerald Coil. These two are the most common. The ones you're actually really looking for are going to be the purple and the red. They're the rarest, so you probably actually already have these two. Next up, we've got Heavy Amolescence, we've got Three of Coins, Glass Needles, and the Mote of Light. You'd purchase the Heavy Amolescence for your events inside of the game, and also to level up your faction packages faster. So, Dead Orbit, Future War Cult, New Monarchy, you can actually level them up fairly quick with the number of Strange Coins it costs to purchase these, compared to the number of Strange Coins it costs to purchase Motes of Light. Three of Coins is to help you farm for exotics, and Glass Needles are to help you re-roll the perks on those exotics. You've also got Mote of Light. Mote of Light being used to level up the inventory items that you have equipped, so your weapons and your armor. So, what exotics should we buy from Xur this week? Well, Fourth Horseman, hell no. Fourth Horseman is probably the worst shotgun you could get in the game. Why? It used to be really, really good back in the day, but it was a full auto shotgun, so it was really nice. But having full auto now isn't actually that important. You've also got no range on this shotgun. It's got really high stability, but no range. The maxed out capacity of this range for the shotgun is actually about 15-20%, and it's not nearly enough to face off against a Matador or a Sidearm or something of that nature. So the Fourth Horseman is off our list for this week. Next up, we've got the Void Fang Torments, is what I like to call them, the Void Fang Vestments for the Warlock, the chest piece. What this does is it normally always had Void Armor, so here's Void Armor right here. Increase armor when using a Void-based subclass, which you will be using for this. You also have the Arc Burn Defense, so if you want to face off against a Striker Titan or any kind of Arc-based, let's see, Stormcaller or Blade Dancer, this is actually really good to use. But try to run the Void Armor with Space Magic and a Nova Bomb, and you will also end up having Hungering Void. Spawn with full grenade energy, and your Axiom Bolt grenade spawns an additional Seeker, allowing you to have your Axiom Bolt work better, and you also spawn. Every single time you die, you instantly have your grenade. So make sure right before you die, you throw a grenade at somebody and see if you can kill them. Try to get that post-mortem kill, and then you'll have your grenade right back after you respawn again. So increased discipline and strength, okay for this build, but intellect and discipline is where I'd like to go. So I'd actually like to re-roll that. But I wouldn't want to re-roll it because I already have the Pulse Rifle ammo and the Fusion Rifle ammo. Fusion Rifles are actually fairly good in Crucible right now. For some reason, some people can't use them, but if you can get your hands on a Fusion Rifle and use it appropriately, they're actually really, really devastating right now, especially the Plan C. Moving on though, the Pulse Rifle ammo. The Pulse Rifle ammo is really good for that Clever Dragon from the Iron Banner, the God Roll Clever Dragon with high caliber rounds and braced frame and rangefinder or hidden hand. That's the kind of Clever Dragon you want to get. And the Iron Banner is going to be up next week, so you better be prepared for that. So, good chest piece. Probably the number one exotic I'd like to purchase from Xur this week, but I already have it, so I don't actually have to do that. Chest of Alpalupe, the noob chest piece. And why I call it that is because it helps you if you're a noob if you die a lot, because your allies are able to respawn you into the game faster. So revives from fallen teammates are faster, and revives from yourself are faster. Supers also generate an extra orb, which will help out your teammates, and it's an all-around decent chest piece. So this would be the second exotic I'd recommend buying this week if you don't have it already. It also has strength and intellect, which is actually completely okay for a hunter. I'd actually rather have intellect or discipline or a strength and discipline role for the hunter, but strength and intellect is completely fine. We've also got the hand cannon ammo, and we've got sidearm ammo. Sidearm and hand cannons are actually really good, so there you go. Then we've got the void burn defense to face off against those, you know, those other tethers and or the Nova bombs, Axiom bolts from the warlocks, or just anything void based. Also helping you face off against those grenades from those titans from the defender bubble as well. We've also got void armor, so you might actually want to couple this with your tether. So run this with your Night Stalker and you'll be good to go. Then we also have the Peregrine Greaves. Now, I'm going to go over the Peregrine Greaves again because this is just, this exotic's interesting. I don't even know if you should get it or if you shouldn't get it. I know personally myself, I don't use it, but there's a lot of people out there that do because they like to run Striker Titan and Shoulder Charge, and it allows you to get more damage on your Shoulder Charge while you're in the air. So, say you have a Warlock floating in the air and you run up to him and you Shoulder Charge him while you're in the air, you're probably guaranteed to kill him instantly. You've also got the fusion rifle ammo and the machine gun ammo, and if you're coupled with the Plan C, or the Silver Dread Arc version from the Iron Banner, this will actually work for your arc double down. So increase the agility for 5 seconds after an arc double kill. So really, really good. And you'll be running shoulder charge, so you'll actually probably be able to slam into somebody with their shoulder, and then you'll actually be able to use the Plan C to take somebody out, or your machine gun with arc damage, and you'll be able to get that arc double down really quickly, and you'll have increased agility. So pretty nice. You've also got discipline and strength. Okay for the build, but I'd rather actually have intellect and discipline for titans. But still an all-around decent, I guess would be a decent leg armor. I'm not really too sure on if you should actually get this leg armor, because once again, I don't use it. So what exotics should you buy? I would say the Chest of Alpalupe and the Void Fang Vestments. This time around, they're actually an okay roll, especially with the Chest of Alpalupe being an intellect roll of 136. Really, really awesome for your hunter. So there you have it, Guardians. I hope you all enjoyed this episode of Xur's Inventory and Location Reviews, episode 11. Wow, it's actually pretty crazy we're on episode 11 already. Rise of Iron's been out for 11 weeks, and we've pretty much sucked the content dry. I hope you all enjoyed this episode, and stay tuned for next week's episode of Xur's Location and Inventory Reviews. If you enjoyed it, drop a like on the video, help it, and make a comment as well. And again, Guardians, as always, stay violent, be privileged, and I'll see you all in the next episode.